Hi, it's Deb from Deb's Days. It's Foster Friday, and I'm back with another edition of The Adventures of Wyatt Earp, the kitten born without any back paws or feet. He's also missing part of one leg. We're on to week 11 of this sweet little guy's life, and we're going to start with a big piece of cheery news. Remember how little Wyatt, with his little cut-up nubs of legs, wouldn't use the litter box? I'm sparing you the pictures, so you get to watch this little video clip instead. But on Christmas Eve, Wyatt started getting more comfortable wearing his little leg prosthesis, and the little boy plopped himself right into the litter box and did his business. Thanks to the protection his little device provides him, he no longer has to step in litter with those little cuts. Way to go, my boy Wyatt! And way to go, generous donor who made them for him. Speaking of the donor, Wyatt had an in-person consultation with her this week. Now, let me tell you, the little boy ate it up. He loved the attention. He was well-loved by everyone who came in contact with him, and he was even a patient during all his fittings. We should have some even better prototypes coming up for him next week. After his appointment on Monday, we've continued working with the one device he already had, and I made some adjustments to it. Last week we had the long white one, but this week we've stuck with the shorter version of it. The one everyone has been chewing on. Well, every kitty, that is. Meaning me, also tried to make a little rounded foot for him out of the materials I had at home. I guess when what you make looks like you just dug crap out of a junk drawer, you look like you don't know what you're doing. Don't worry, expert help is on the way. And I'm not talking about Wyatt's help in trying to get it taken off. We have new little special presents coming up for him, made by someone who definitely knows what she's doing. It's taking a village to raise this little guy, and he sure has a lot of people pulling for him. Thank you to all who have been watching him, working with him, and sending your positive thoughts his way. I do have to throw my husband in there as being one of Wyatt's biggest supporters. If you've read the blog over the years, you know I've mentioned how he was born with cerebral palsy and only has use of one side of his body. I even discussed it in one of my cruising videos a couple years back, the one where we lived on the Caribbean Princess ship for a month. It's the one where he showed off how hard it was getting into a cabin with a cup of coffee, but also how having the new princess medallion unlocking the cabin doors was a great help for disabled people for things like that. My husband, having lived with a physical disability all of his life, has been a huge cheerleader of Wyatt's. He knows he'll adapt and figure it out and make his way through the world, just like he did. Kindred spirits, those two are. The week ended on a bit of a down note for Wyatt, as the bottom of one of his little nubs, the one on the shorter leg, broke open and got infected. It's been painful for him, and he keeps it far off the floor, which has, in turn, turned him into something new. A three-legged cat. At first, a tentative three-legged cat, but now, just look at the things this little guy can do with just three legs. Remember when he struggled to get between the two cat trees with all four legs? Well, with three legs? No problem. Head back again? You betcha. No problem getting from the cat tree to the couch either. When he was little, jumping off the couch looked like this. What does three-legged Wyatt look like jumping now? Nailed the landing. And do his siblings give three-legged cat Wyatt Earp a break when they're wrestling? Heck no. Nope. No way. Has it stopped him from climbing or from one of his sister Annie Oakley's surprise attacks? Nope. Thankfully, he's on the mend and hardwood floor, here we come. Well, maybe. Next week, we'll keep working on the climbing and jumping and running and three-legging and hopefully all as a healthy cat. You can find the next week's video and the past week's videos by subscribing to my YouTube channel or by going to debsdays.com and clicking on the Fostering Kitten section. Also, if you're interested in helping support the work being done with foster kittens like Wyatt Earp, check out simplycats.org. Simply Cats is a cageless, no-kill feline adoption center here in Boise and is the only shelter I work with. It's also where Wyatt and the rest of his siblings will be up for adoption this month. See you next week for the next episode of The Adventures of Wyatt.